What's up guys, Noah from Stage 3 Motorsports here, and today we're going to be showing you how to do an install on this BuiltRight dash mount panel for your 09-14 F-150 or Raptor. This is a pretty quick and simple install overall, so let's just jump right into it. First things first, we need to pop up and remove this little rubber mat from inside our tray. And there's nothing holding that in other than just these little tabs at the bottom, so you can kind of just peel it up and get it out of the way. And then you'll see that that's going to reveal these two little screws that hold the tray into the dash. So we're going to use a ratchet and a 7mm socket to loosen these up, and then we can pull them out entirely. So now we're going to take the dash mount and we're going to set it in place with these two curved tabs with the holes in them facing the back, and those are going to line up with the two screws that we just removed. So what we want to do here is actually run our new screws through this to kind of hold it in place, and so you'll have two longer kind of coarse threaded screws with a Phillips head top on them that are going to mount that in the back, and then we can actually mark where we need to drill the holes for the front of the tray to lock this thing in place. Obviously, with the windshield being angled, it can be a little bit difficult to get a screwdriver in here. So if you have a short screwdriver or a actual Phillips head bit that you can use with your ratchet, that's gonna work best, so you actually have the space to turn these. And we're not gonna go tighten them down all the way, just enough to keep this in place. Okay, so our dash mount is in position. It looks like everything's squared up. Trying to get a Sharpie through the holes though to actually mark the holes below it is pretty difficult, so I like to use a small screwdriver with sort of a sharpened head on it to run this through, and then we can sort of score the plastic a little bit where we need to cut it. We'll just do this on both sides here, make a little indentation. There we go. Now we can remove the two back screws. We're gonna pull the actual dash mount off of this, and then we're gonna actually remove the entire tray with that so we can pull it out, drill it separately, and mount the front, and then we'll be able to put this all back together and it'll be locked in the way we want. All right, so with the dash mount off, the way you're going to remove this tray is by kind of popping up the back section here. And if you can't get your fingers around it, you can use a plastic pry tool or body trim tool to get that moved. And then you're going to slide it forward, and you'll see that there's just a tab here that's holding it in underneath the front of the dash. So once you slide that back, it'll come out really simply. Now, because we do have a Raptor with the upgraded audio package, there is a speaker in our tray. So if you do have that, you're gonna wanna just unplug this little harness right here so you can get it all the way free. But if you don't have the speaker in there, you shouldn't have to worry about it, and you can just lift the tray out. And now we're gonna drill out these holes. So I've marked the two areas with Sharpie that I scored earlier in the truck. And then we're gonna use a 9/64 drill bit to make two little pilot holes through the plastic. And then we can step that up to a 1/4 inch drill bit for the final hole size that'll accommodate the new hardware. So with our two new holes drilled out, when we take the dash mount, you'll see that the fronts should line up just about perfectly, and then the rears will still be lined up with the holes that were already in it from factory. So all we need to do is take our new hardware, which will be a screw and a nylock nut with a little washer that's gonna run through, and we'll tighten down the two front screws. Then we can actually drop this back into place, attach the rears, and we'll be good to go. The two nuts on the back are going to require just a 3/8 inch socket, and then the tops are Phillips heads like I mentioned, so we can use a regular screwdriver to get that tightened down. All right, there we go. So both front screws are attached. The thing is nice and squared up inside the tray, and our two holes in the back still line up. So if you're tightening it down and they aren't lined up, make sure you just loosen it, kind of adjust it a little bit and get it straight. And then now we can go ahead and drop this into place. Now, once again, if you do have a speaker in your tray, you're gonna wanna reattach the wiring harness before you mount everything. So I'm just gonna clip that in real quick. And now we can slot the front of the tray in and the back will drop into place. Now grab the two longer screws that we used for test fitting earlier. We can drop these back into the holes on the rear of the mount. And this time we're gonna tighten them down for good, and that'll wrap up the install for us. And just like that, guys, we are done with our BuiltRight dash mount install. You can see that this thing's locked in here plenty sturdy, and this gives you just a great platform where you can mount a phone or a GPS or even something like a VHF or CB radio up here. Just a lot of different utility to this actual mount. But the other thing that's worth noting is that we do still have our rubber tray, and this obviously isn't gonna fit back in there with the mount in place. That's really not a big deal, but if you do ever pull the mount out, this rubber tray will fit and it'll actually cover up the holes that you already drilled for it. So it's fairly non-invasive in that way. So if you needed to remove it, it doesn't look like you've been messing with your dash or Swiss cheese and everything by cutting holes out of it. With all that being said, this is gonna be a wrap on our BuiltRight install. As always, thank you guys for watching. And if you're interested in picking up one of these mounts for your truck, you can head down in the description below. We'll have a link that you can click, and I'll see you guys next time.